Hello. I am Professor Yuan, and today on Technically You we are covering part 1 on Unified Threat Management Systems. What is a Unified Threat Management System? A Unified Threat Management, UTM, system is a type of network hardware appliance, virtual appliance or cloud service that provides a multi-layered defense that protects businesses from various security threats by combining and integrating multiple security services and functions into a single solution. One of the great advantages of an UTM system is that it eliminates an organization having to work with multiple threat protection software, appliances, and vendors. With a UTM, everything is under a single platform and managed and maintained via a single user interface. Capabilities of a unified threat management system. UTM systems are all-in-one systems containing several network security features and functionalities, including data loss prevention. UTM data loss prevention enables you to detect data breaches and exfiltration attempts, and then prevent them. The data loss prevention system monitors sensitive data, and when it identifies an attempt by a bad actor to steal the data, it blocks the attempt, therefore protecting the data. Antispam services. The UTM Antispam services scans all in and outbound simple mail transfer protocol, SMTP, emails and will either block or tag incoming email-based attacks. Anti-spam filtering enables businesses to use third-party server-based spam block lists or to create their own local whitelists and blacklists to filter email messages. UTM antivirus services scans email and web application traffic for malware. Some UTM systems scan for other network security threats carried in application traffic, such as instant messaging services. Anti-malware. Unified threat management services also protect networks against malware by detecting it and then responding. A UTM can be pre-configured to detect known malware, filtering it out of data streams and blocking it from penetrating systems. UTM can also use sandboxing as an anti-malware measure. With sandboxing, a cell inside the computer is confined to a sandbox that captures the suspicious file. Even though the malware is allowed to run, the sandbox prevents it from interacting with other programs in the computer. Application control. UTM devices and services may also offer application control to whitelist applications and flag which applications may and may not be used, and when. Application control is important for network security because many apps are either malicious or contain vulnerabilities that attackers can use to compromise network security. Firewall. UTM firewalls restrict the establishment of network connections between hosts inside and outside the organization with the intention of reducing or eliminating exposure to external hosts, networks or protocols that are known to be vectors for network threats. A UTM firewall has the ability to scan incoming and outgoing traffic for viruses, malware, phishing attacks, spam, attempts to intrude on the network, and other cybersecurity threats. Because UTM firewalls examine both the data coming in and out of your network, they can also prevent devices within your network from being used to spread malware to other networks that connect to it. Intrusion prevention. A UTM system can provide an organization with intrusion prevention capabilities, which detects then prevents attacks. This functionality is often referred to as an intrusion prevention system, IPS. To identify threats, an IPS analyzes packets of data, looking for patterns known to exist in threats. When one of these patterns is recognized, the IPS stops the attack. Intrusion detection. With a UTM intrusion detection, IDs, malicious data packets will be detected and reported, and the IT team will be responsible for either taking actions to address the threat. The steps taken to stop the attack can be automated or performed manually. The UTM will also log the malicious event. These logs can then be analyzed and used to prevent other attacks in the future. Thank you for watching part 1 of our series on Unified Threat Management Systems. We really appreciate you spending time with us. If you like this or any other Technically You video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel.